first start line dancing, you'll be shown some basic steps. The first step that I teach are walks with a touch. I'll show you.
Our weight is on our left, that's our anchor step. We have no weight on our right foot, that's the foot that's going to move. We're going to walk three steps with a touch. Walk right, walk left, walk right, touch left beside. Now we're going to go back. Back left, back right, back left with a touch. Do it with me. The counts are one, two, three, touch, four. Going back on the foot that's just touched. Back left, right, left, touch. Once more, a little bit faster. Walk, two, three, and touch. Back, two, three, and touch. So that's just walking forward and walking back with the touch. The next steps you'll most probably learn are side touches. So we've walked forward with a touch, now we're going to walk step to the side. We step our foot about the hip width of our shoulder, no further than that. So we step, all our weight is on that right foot, we touch left beside it. We're going to do the same to our left. Step left, touch right. One more time. Step right, all our weight is on it, touch left. Step left, all our weight is on it, touch right. The counts are 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll do it a little bit faster. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I'll show you the next step, which would be a side together side touch. So our weight is left, our right foot is ready to move. We step to the side, our weight is on our right. We bring our left foot together, we change weight. We step to the side and touch our left foot beside it. We'll do the same to the left. Step left to the side, all our weight is on our left. We bring our right foot beside it, we change our weight onto it. We step our left foot to the side, touch right. Let's have a look at that. Side together, side touch, and to the left, side together, side touch. We'll now go on to vines. A vine is a basic step in all line dancing. We step, our weight is on our left. You can see there's no weight on the right foot, just balancing on your toes there, or the ball of your foot more like it. We step left, right to the side. We cross left behind. Our weight is actually on that foot. Now we're stepping to the side. That is a vine. Now there's different endings. This one can just be a touch. There'll be different endings on all vines. I'll just show you an example. Side behind, side heel. I'll show you another ending. Side behind, side hitch. So you'll see a vine is the three steps, but the ending is the fourth step. So, one, cross two, step three, touch four. Then we'll do the same thing to the left. We step to the left is one. Cross right behind, all our weight is on it, no weight on that left foot is two. We step left to the side is three, touch four. I'll show you the endings to the left side. There's many different endings, these are just an example. Side behind, side and heel. I'll show you another one. Side behind, side and hitch. You'll learn more about those as we go along. I'm just showing you some examples. So, just the vine with the touch. One, two, three, touch four, five, six, seven, touch eight. Also in line dancing, you've just heard me count eight. In most line dances, it's eight counts. In waltzing, it's six, but most of them are eight. And these are called single counts. So, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now that I've spoken about single counts, I'll explain to you about syncopated. Syncopated has three movements and three counts. I'll show you a shuffle. A shuffle slowly is side, together, side. The counts to that are one and two. That second step is shorter. So it's one and two. It's still a low motion to the floor though. Even though I'm just showing it slowly, we're not hopping as we're doing that. We're keeping our head as if there's a shelf above our head.
So we're side together, side. Our knees are doing the work. You can notice your knees are bending. That's a little bit, that's called flexing. So a shuffle is side together, side. Weight is on our right. Now to the left, left, together, left. That second together step is shorter. It's a pushing motion. Side together. You're almost just using the ball of your foot. Together, side. So your weight is not on that second step because it's going to be doing something. And side together, side. To the left, side together, side. That's the shuffle. I'll just do the counts for you in a shuffle now. One and two, three and four. Again, one and two, three and four. Now we can have a shuffle going forward, back or to the side. I'll show you a forward shuffle coming towards you. Right together the right, left together the left. So you can hear that together is shorter. One and two, three and four. I'll show you the forward shuffle this way. The second step is short. One and two, three and four. It's just short, so it's a pushing motion. This brings me into a triple step or a cha-cha step. A cha-cha step is syncopated as well, but it's short, but it's normally used in Latin. So it would be one and two. One and two. That's called a cha-cha step or a triple step. I'll just show you a triple step moving forward. It's just sharper than a shuffle. I'll give you the two. A shuffle is forward together the forward. A triple is forward together the forward. It has more of a rumba cha-cha beat to it. And it's normally not travelling too much. Forward together the forward. We can also have triples on the spot. I'll show you a triple on the spot. Often after a mambo. I'll show you a mambo. Side rock together is a mambo. We're rocking to the right, coming back to the left, bringing our foot ready to a right, left, right. So it's a side rock, left, right, left, and a side rock, right, left, right, and a side rock, left, right, left. We can do a forward rock, right, left, right. We can do a back. Rock, right, left, right. You see the triple has more of a hip movement in it, but it's the shortness of the steps that's giving you the hip movement. For that, well, let's recap what we've learned. We've learned to start off with walk, two, three, and touch. Back, two, three, and touch. Now we've learned side touches. Step to the right, touch left. Step to the left, touch right. We then learned side together, side touches. Side together, side touch. And to the left, side together, side touch. We then went on to shuffles. Forward together, forward. Forward together, forward. This way. Forward together, forward. Forward together, forward. Shuffle to the side. Right together, the right. Shuffle to the left. Our left foot's already out there. Left together, the left. For ease, just to practice, you might want to bring your feet together, just for practice. Right together, the right. Then for the left one, just get even. Put your weight on the right foot, ready to move left. Left together, the left. As you practice that, then put them together. Right together, the right. Left together, the left. I'll now explain a step block step. This is often used in my basic classes. We step forward on our right foot. We're locking our left foot behind. It's like a crossing motion, but there's actually like a feeling of a lock, then stepping. I'll show you to the back. Step, lock, step. Again, it's a pushing motion on that second one. Step, lock, step. So the lock is the crossing behind. You don't have to cross too far. Step, lock, step. Step, lock, step. Show it to you this way. Right, lock, right. Left, lock, left. Another step I haven't explained to you is step scuff. So I often use those in my very basic classes. A scuff. A scuff is the ball of your foot making like an arc movement as it brushes forward. It can be a brush or a scuff. This one is with the ball of our foot. You can have a heel scuff too, which obviously is a heel doing it. This is just the ball of our foot scuff, like that. So it's forward on your right, scuff forward. Step forward on your left, scuff forward. Scuff. Step forward on your right, scuff forward. Step forward on your left. If you had more room, you'd scuff. I'll show you side on. Step right, scuff forward. Step left, scuff forward. Step right, scuff forward. Step left, scuff forward. While we're here, I'll show you a step called back heels. We step back on our right, pick our heel up from where it was and just put it down again. That's called a heel tap. Step back on our left, tap our right heel where it is. We're just picking our foot up and tapping our heel. Stepping right back, tapping our heel on the left. Stepping left back, where our foot is, we're just picking up and putting it down. So we'll have forward scuffs and back heels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think that's enough for you. That's quite a lot of steps to have learned. You will learn those steps over normally 8 to 10 weeks. So enjoy.